हाय, आई हैव जस्ट जॉइंड एस्कॉर्ट्स और आज मैं अपने जॉब के बारे में कुछ सीखने जा रहा हूँ।
चार मिनट 12 सेकंड, इससे ज्यादा ये काम नहीं कर पाएगा। पर आप जानते हैं कि एक समय ऐसा था जब भारत में जितने किसान हैं सब ऐसे ही काम करते थे और दुनिया मानती थी कि कुछ बदलने की जरूरत क्यों है। तब एक इंसान ने कहा, क्यों नहीं,
क्यों नहीं।
जब खेतों में बीज उगले उसमें पसीना क्यों, गुदगुदी क्यों नहीं, बल का औजार बैल नहीं, हल का हल क्यों नहीं। जब औरों ने पूछा क्यों, हमने कहा क्यों नहीं।
The partition destroyed my home and my wealth, but it could not destroy my spirit.
शून्य से हुई थी शुरुआत, पर शून्य से खत्म नहीं। जब औरों ने पूछा क्यों, हमने कहा क्यों नहीं।
It's the farmers who feed the nation. Why not give them a reason to smile? Mechanization would have to rule the fields.
जहां सूर्य जल वायु आ सकते गांव में, वहां नई तकनीक नई सोच क्यों नहीं।
I had a dream to bring the world's best to India and offering India's best to the world.
देना है जवाब हर सवाल का, और सवाल से पहले क्यों नहीं। हर चुनौती के अंदर हम अवसर चुन के लाते क्यों नहीं।
When the world said, Why not just make peace with the foreign giant taking over your company? I asked, why not fight him back?
जब सफर में हो सफलता की गति, तो उससे जुड़ेंगे लोग क्यों नहीं? नींव पुरानी ही सही, पर उसमें नौजवान सोच क्यों नहीं? जब औरों ने पूछा क्यों, हमने कहा क्यों नहीं? क्यों से पूछो, क्यों नहीं?
When the world asked, is this a family business? I asked, why not change the very definition of family?
Every employee, every future employee, every dealer, every farmer, every Indian is a part of our family. Because we were never about just building a company. We have always been building India.
When talented young blood wants to surge in the veins of your company, you must have done something right. Then you are ready to set new standards, not just for the country, but for the world.
To create history, you have to know history. We have done it before, and we will do it again.
Times are changing, but our values will prevail.
The future is not about pushing the product, it's about pushing a solution.
जब औरों ने पूछा क्यों, हमने कहा क्यों नहीं।
I want every farm to be mechanized and infrastructure to be of global standards. In 2012, the ex-president of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, visited Escorts and gave us a mission to partner India to produce more than 350 million tons of food by 2025.
जब आप कुछ नया, कुछ अद्भुत करना चाहेंगे, तो दुनिया आपसे पूछेगी क्यों? तब आप बस एक ही चीज कहना, क्यों नहीं?
क्यों नहीं? बावड़ी पूछ, किधर जा रहा भागे भागे?
वापस काम पे, लॉकडाउन खत्म ना है?
अच्छा लॉकडाउन खत्म? भाई तन्ने एक नंबर की बात बताऊं, सावधान तो अभी भी रहना पड़े।
ओह दद्दू, कब तक ही सावधान वाला गेम खेलेंगे? खेतों की ताजी हवा खानी है, हाईवे पे जान नहीं लगाई, जल्दी केयरफुल रहो, केयरफुल रहो।
हेलो, लॉकडाउन खत्म हुआ है, कोरोना नहीं, स्टे सेफ स्टे अलर्ट, समझा?
नहीं समझू क्या?
ओ मेरी बात समझ छोटे।
पर दद्दू, इस वायरस से हम फाइट तो कर लेंगे ना?
अरे टेंशन ना ले छोटे, मुंह तोड़ जवाब देंगे।
अच्छा,
देश फिर से खड़ा होगा, हम दौड़ेंगे, देश दौड़ेगा।
वाह दद्दू वाह।
एस्कॉर्ट्स, देश के साथ।
Good afternoon, dear shareholders. On behalf of the board of directors and the entire Escorts Group, I welcome you all to the 75th annual general meeting of your company. As a requisite quorum being present through the video conference for the AGM, now I begin with the business of the meeting. In view of COVID-19 pandemic and social distancing norms, this meeting is being held through video conference and through other audio-visual means and is in compliance with the Ministry of Corporate Affairs circulars and Securities and Exchange Board of India. The company has taken all feasible efforts under the present circumstances to ensure that the shareholders are provided with an opportunity to participate in the annual general meeting and also vote. The registrar of directors and the key managerial personnel and their shareholding and the registrar of contracts and the arrangements in which directors are interested are available for inspection of members electronically during this meeting. I would now request our company secretary, Mr. Satendra Chauhan, and compliance officer to take us through the general instructions pertaining to the annual general meeting. Satendra, over to you.
Thank you, Mr. Nanda. As this meeting is held through video conference, I would like to mention a few things. That every member who has joined is muted by default to avoid any disturbance arising from background noise and ensure seamless conduct of the meeting. As the question and answer session starts, we will announce the name of person one by one. On calling the name, the speaker shoulder has to unmute himself or herself. If the speaker shoulder faces any connectivity issue, we will ask the next registered shoulder to speak in turn, and the previous shareholders will be allowed to speak post all registered shareholders have finished asking questions. Also, members may post their queries in the message box provided on their screen, and we shall appropriately respond to them post the AGM. We at Escorts are committed to answer all the queries of the shareholders. The questions which we may not be able to answer due to bad network connectivity or on the part of the company or the shareholders, or for any other reason whatsoever, the shareholders can email their queries to the email address provided in the notice of AGM, and we will email the answer post the annual general meeting. The entire proceedings of the meetings are being recorded.
Thank you, Satendra. Taking the meeting forward, I will introduce the board members who are present and are joining through video conference. Mr. Hardeep Singh, non-executive, non-independent director. Mr. Singh is also the chairman of Stakeholder Relationship Committee of the company. Mr. P.H. Ravi Kumar, independent director. Mr. Ravi Kumar is chairman of Audit Committee and the chairman of the Nomination and Remuneration Compensation Committee of your company. Ms. Vibha Paul Rishi, independent director. Dr. Satanu Bihoria, independent director. Ms. Natasha Nanda, whole-time director. Ms. Nanda is also the chairperson of Corporate Social Responsibility Committee of the company. Mr. Shailendra Agarwal, Executive Director. Mr. Sunil Kant Munjal, Independent Director. Ms. Tania Dubash, Independent Director. Mr. Harish N. Salve, Independent Director. Mr. Dai Watanabe, Non-Executive, Non-Independent Director. And Mr. Yoji Tomiyama, Non-Executive, Non-Independent Director. Also present are the key executives of your company joining through video conference from their respective locations, including Mr. Bharat Madan, our Group Chief Financing Officer, CFO and Corporate Head, Mr. Shenu Agarwal, our CEO for Escorts Agri Machinery, Mr. Ajay Mandar, CEO for Escorts Construction Equipment, and Mr. Amit Singhal, who is a Group HR Head and Deputy Corporate Head. And of course, Mr. Sitinder Chauhan, our Company Secretary and Compliance Officer. Our following auditors are also present in this AGM. Mr. Ashish Gupta, partner from Walker Chandiok and Company LLP, our statutory auditors. Mr. Gavish Oberoi, partner from Ernst & Young, along with his team as our internal auditors. Mr. Jayant Gupta, practicing company secretary, our secretarial auditors. And Ms. Parvati Venkatesh from Ramnath Iyer and Company, cost auditors of the company. Thank you everyone for your support and continuous guidance. In the Q&A session, shareholders, you may please feel free to ask your questions directly to the auditors. Moving on to my main speech, dear shareholders, the world has been hit by an unfortunate pandemic affecting human lives and businesses across the globe. Your company has done its best to tide through this ongoing crisis. At Escorts, safety and health of our employees, dealers, suppliers, partners, and well-being of our ecosystem has been one of the most important responsibilities. Last year, as pandemic started, we rolled out work from home policy for our office employees and enabled them with IT infrastructure necessary for them to operate from the safety of their homes. Employees in factories were provided with safety work environment by ensuring adherence of all safety norms, including frequent testing of the entire workforce. A COVID insurance cover was provided where any employee testing positive would be eligible for immediate financial assistance. Enhanced medical hospitalization insurance coverage and a special leaves were some of the other measures taken by the company. We also extended support to our dealers and our supplier partners in many different ways, including financial benefits to our dealer sales or service staff members. We also supported our customers in a very unique way by providing them with health insurance cover on purchase of any Escorts tractor and or construction equipment machine products. Under the banner of COVID Kavach, several vaccination camps were conducted at our various dealerships, as you can see on the screen. And I do want to thank our dealership community for extending and supporting this cause and reaching out to our community of farmers in giving them and making this vaccination available. Thank you. We are also pleased to share that all our workforce have now been vaccinated. At least the first dosage has been given, and the second dosage is now happening as we speak. And in the next few weeks, the entire workforce of Escorts would have completed the first and the second dosage. I also want to thank all our doctors and our partners from the hospitals to enable and to make this happen. Thank you. The vaccination drive has now also been extended to serve our communities in and around Faridabad district. We have vaccinated more than 15,000 residents so far, and we intend to continue this drive for another few weeks to have maximum coverage. Again, my thanks to the CSR committee members and to everyone who are extending the support to give this to the communities. We did our best to continue to provide agriculture equipment and services to the farmers during the COVID times. And that is one of our purpose, and we shall always continue to give our best of services to our farming community. This pandemic has also helped us in preparing a future-ready charter which focuses on smooth and efficient conduct of the business, adopting newer, smarter, digital ways of doing business. Dear shareholders, It is a moment of great pride that today's annual general meeting marks the 75th year of Escorts. The journey started with a vision of our founder, Mr. H.P. Nanda, to spread prosperity and impact lives within our nation and across the globe. After 75 years, we continue to remain guided by this vision. On the way, we witnessed some good and some challenging times, but our commitment to nation building never wavered. Kindly allow me to share through our brief video some glimpses of this journey of the last 70 years. Thank you. We are committed to continue this journey to create value for our stakeholders, transforming our organization to an institution delivering excellence and contribute to the growth story of our great nation. We shall continue to directly contribute to nation building in areas of agriculture, mobility, and infrastructure development, and through this spread prosperity and impact more and more lives across the country and in other markets in the globe. Let me switch gears to the present and showcase to you our results for the fiscal year FY21. In many ways, FY21 has been a milestone one for us. Despite the COVID challenges and disruptions, your company displayed a great sense of solidarity and resilience to bring out our best financial results so far in the last 75 years. We achieved ever highest consolidated revenue. We produced and sold more than 100,000 tractors for the very first time in a single year. Our consolidated net profit was also on an all-time record. We also achieved our ever highest operating margin. And I want to thank all the team members for their excellent dedication and focus for achieving these results. Now, moving to the agri business vertical, I would like to showcase and walk you through the financial results. The domestic tractor industry volume for FY21 went up by 26% to almost 900,000 units, which is again among the highest in any year. The industry is moving towards a 1 million mark, faster than what we had anticipated. This just showcased the resilience and the strength and the growth opportunities in our rural market. Our total tractor volume for FY21 has been at 106,741 units, which was up by 24% in comparison to FY20. We are continuously leveraging the strength of our two key brands, FarmTrac and PowerTrac, both through differentiated products as well as through a dual distribution strategy. Our total dealer count in India stands at 1,100 plus, the most of our new dealers now coming up in the southern and the western region. We are very, very committed to ensure that we are adequately covered across the country for any customer who wants a product from Escorts to avail of these products anywhere in the country. On the export side, shipments out of India at industry level were at 16.5%, whereas exports volume for Escorts grew nearly two times in the industry. This is driven again by focus on product developments, focus on appointing dealership and channel partners in countries where we were not present, and also it is a matter of pride that our partnership with Kubota is also enabling us to reach out to markets where we were unable to do so in the past. And I think the combination of great products, enhanced channel coverage, that the export volumes will continue to grow in the years to come. All the efforts coupled with the cost controls, many measures that we took in the operating team on looking at product mix, looking at various other operating areas of control that we did, that your company was able to achieve its record margin at 18.2% for this current fiscal, which was significantly improved from the previous fiscal at 13%. We have always at Escorts looked at cash, margins, return on capital employed, and margin is one of the key focuses the company will continue to look at and look at ways of how we can be lean, agile, and improve on these margins as we move forward with our performances for the future years. We are continuously rolling out new products in line with evolving requirements of our customers. And I'm extremely proud, dear shareholders, to present to you a few of the awards that we have won in the last 12 months. And I do want to recognize great efforts of our designers in TS Scott's ecosystem who are innovatively and disruptively are creating a differentiation on the application of our products, both in the farm track and power track, and for the application requirements and demands of our country in the domestic and in the international markets. And this will continue as one of the main focus of our growth, to grow with technology and to grow with products of excellence. And we as a company are also investing largely and hugely on creating the capabilities in terms of infrastructure, both in terms of soft and all the equipment that we require for us to enable this aspiration. As you can see on the screen, these were some of the awards. So very humbled, and we will continue to drive more and develop more products of these kinds. Coming on to construction equipment businesses, here are some of the highlights. The nationwide lockdown in the first half of the fiscal 2020 severely impacted ongoing construction projects, forcing a slowdown in retail financing, adversely affecting construction equipment industry in the first half of FY21. The first wave of COVID subsided. The government took significant measures in providing stimulus packages, which resulted in positivity and revival of the projects, due to which we were able to record a 34% growth in the H2 of FY21. We had some supply chain related issues, but the team did its best in collaborating with our supplier partners, and I do want to acknowledge and thank our supplier partners for doing their best to enable Escorts to bring back its production volumes, and therefore we did end the year with the EBIT margin, which was at 3.6%, and this is a margin that we maintained even with the difficulties of volume and difficulty of the H1, as I mentioned. But our focus is to improve on these margins to a double digit, and all preparations are being worked out to ensure the products and the cost reduction and other measures to be in place to achieve the objective of a double digit EBIT margin. And that is going to be a focus which we will continue to strive for. During the year, we also reclassified our customer segments into value and premium. And to address both these distinct segments, we launched a new range of white line construction equipment. The existing yellow line serves to customers seeking value for money, and the new white line caters to the emerging requirements of fleet owners and corporate customers who need higher spec premium offering. As you can see on the screen, we have the yellow range and the white range recently launched and well received. Now I would like to briefly move on to the railway business as well. Despite a challenging year, impacted by heavily reduced movement of trains in the country, sales were marginally up by 0.4%. The EBIT margin for railway business for FY21 stood at 16%. Our order book for railway equipment stood at approximately 340 crores as on 1st of April 2021. In comparison to 510 crores in the previous fiscal. We hope to soon rebuild our order book as the sentiment improves and the traffic on rail transportation increases in the country. During the year, we also made an entry into the metro segment for the very first time. We also introduced several new products, and I'm happy to share, shareholders, that 59%, nearly 60% of our railway revenues are now coming from the new products that we have launched in the last 3 years. So great effort from our research and development team, and the approvals that we have received, that the growth charter of what we've seen will continue even in the years ahead. The railway sector is bound to revive soon, and we will be back on the growth as what we expect for the next 2 to 3 years. Now let me move and summarize the overall company's key financial performance for the FY21. The consolidated total income was reported at 7,174.8 crores, which was up by 21%. We recorded our highest ever tractor volume, up by 24% at 106,741 tractors. Our consolidated EBITDA was at 1,126.8 crores and operating margin up at 16.1%. Our consolidated net profit was recorded at 871.6 crores, which is highest ever, and was up by 85%. I'm happy to announce that and encouraged by the excellent results in FY21 that your board of directors have recommended a total dividend of 75% per equity share, including one-time Platinum Jubilee Year special dividend of 25% to commensurate the 75th financial year of your company. Some other financial highlights, as you can see on the screen, I will allow a couple of seconds for you to absorb these numbers. I want to pay my gratitude to all Escorts employees, especially our union, who braved the pandemic by adopting utmost measures on safety and hygiene while still driving record results for the company. It is easier said than done, and therefore these real heroes deserve all the praises from all of us today. Thank you, gentlemen, for your for your focus and for your loyalty, for making our plant safe and our offices safe, and for us to have done what we did. Thank you. We are very proud of you. Moving on to the vision 2022, if you recall, a few years back, we had shared about our vision, and I'd like to walk you through the hits and misses. So, dear shareholders, despite some pushback from the pandemic situation resulting in disruption of our supply chain, our ability to produce enough tractors was a challenge. But we did do some achievements in actually meeting a target 1 year earlier in terms of our EBITDA targets. As you can see on the screen, our return on capital employed targets were also achieved 1 year prior to the commitment of FY22. Exports are showing some very healthy trends of growth, but in terms of market share, we had a slight setback. As I mentioned, FY21 had many challenges of COVID situations. As you are aware, many of our suppliers who are present across the nation had severe to mild lockdowns, which disrupted the logistics supply to our factory gates. So while the demand was very, very encouraging, but we were unable to roll out the tractors because of the logistic and the pandemic constraint related supply chain issues. But this market share of 11.6, as you can see in the screen, the company did well from FY16 to FY20 to increase its market share. But this last year of 11.3 is a temporary situation, and I can assure you, in the years ahead, your company will target and achieve the aspiration of what we had communicated in our FY22 aspiration of the market share. So I would like to give confidence to all of you that for FY22 and years ahead, your company will showcase the market share growth in pan-India and across the globe for export volumes. As we have completed the FY22, your company and the board also sat down to think about the future. The future is exciting, it's disruptive, and we also want to ensure that we are prepared at Escorts to be a part of a future that we can be proud about. So in these pandemic times, we did not lose focus on the future of what we need to prepare for. So I'm happy to share that the company worked on preparing a medium-term business plan, and we have now a plan which is reflecting up till FY 2025. And today I would like to walk you through very, very briefly about the objectives and the framework of the aspirations and the character and the foundation upon which we will build our business focus for the next 3 to 4 years. As you can see on the screen, our company will always strive to look at profitability. We want to lead on margins, and the company will look at all aspects of what we can do to disrupt the way we do our business in the most innovative of ways to increase our margins to levels to where we can possibly in the future become a benchmark. We also aspire to become a company that is one of the fastest growing tractor company in India. We aspire to achieve leadership position in the India-led exports, And as I had mentioned to you in the previous part of my speech, with many partnership with our channel partners and a strategic partnership that we have now with Kubota, through the joint venture that we have with them, that we will have access to more channel and geographies, which will also enable us to improve our footprint in markets, in the overseas market, which will help us to achieve this aspiration of India-led exporter. We are also on the path of the change that we would like to make in the next 4 years. Numbers, of course, are important in terms of profitability, margin, ROCE, but we also have to change with the changing times of the environment. So in the last 75 years, we are proud to have done a great service on the tractorization part of the impact that your company has done in the country. But the company has to also now change towards the mechanization part, whereby now we're looking at productivity. The farmer today is looking at a complete solution, and your company is making a lot of strategic measures of creating products which will enable the farm mechanization part of a complete solution offering. And also have the tech part related to precision farming, which is also a focus that we are going to enable in the next 4 years. So we are very excited that in the next 4 years, apart from the ambitious numbers we have taken on top line growth, on margin improvement, that the company will improve disruptively on its offering on mechanization and complete solution to our farming community. So on the mechanization front, as you are aware, we have launched a brand called Farm Power. That's a brand on all our implements, and that's going to become an important aspect of our growth in FY25. We shall also work on other disruptive platforms, which I have spoken in my earlier AGM speeches as well, on Escorts Crop Solution, which is a farming as a service, still very small at the current stage, but we do believe in the future the farming community need to be given a choice of ownership to that of usage of products, which will enable them to make decisions as for the profitability and the revenue is concerned for the community, for them. In the construction business, we aspire to attain leadership in our crane businesses for end-to-end solution. We are continuously evolving, disrupting, and investing on products that will continue to for Escorts to keep its lead position in the material handling segment of its cranes. On the railway equipment, we would continue to build and introduce new technologies to further expand our product portfolio. As I mentioned, in the last fiscal, we have made our entry into metro. We are looking at various partnerships whereby we can technologically expand our product portfolio to tap into larger opportunity the railway segment offers, both in the domestic market and also for the international markets, which is something that we still need to do a lot of. But I'm confident vis-a-vis with the products that we are building that we will find opportunities, not just in India, but also in the overseas market. We also want to build in Escorts for the future. You know, we all know that diversity in terms of gender, in terms of the age, average age that we would like to bring in to our company, because today the youth is playing an important aspect of the decision making of the future. So we need to ensure that we are future ready by having an environment that attracts the youth, allows a culture where we can allow the youth and our Escortians to innovate, disrupt, and think of a future that could be created in this platform as we have done in the last 7.5 decades. With that aspiration in mind, we've started Rajan Danda Innovation Lab. It's a very humble beginning where we are looking and creating an environment where we can look at products, where we can create products of the future. Electric tractor was one such endeavor that your company made. As you're aware, in exclusive as a brand that is a platform of innovation, 4 years ago, electric tractor was exhibited. We have also shown other products of disruption, such as a prototype, which I'll be covering later in my speech. And also an RTV product that we had showcased. But what I really want to convey is innovation, disruption, and changing the status quo is going to be an important character of your company while we build a future that we all can be proud about. We shall also continue to further integrate the sustainability goals adhering to the global sustainability norms across all our ecosystem, which is something we are totally committed towards. I have already spoken about a very key focus on ROI, ROCE, cash, margin. Top line, of course, has to happen in terms of its growth vis-a-vis the ambitions that I've already talked about. I do want to thank the entire fraternity and the leadership team and my board for putting in a very, very exciting script of FY25. As I conclude my main part of the speech of today's AGM, I really want to extend our gratitude to our customers for their faith and for their participation and for their encouragement to all of us. Customers are the reason why we come to operate. Customers are our main focus, and I do with sincerity thank them for all what we have done in the last 7.5 decades and for the future of what we will do with their support. I also would want to thank all the Escortians who have played a very important role in this transitioning that we are making as a company and the performance that we have, which I'm presenting to you. I am just a face. I am just a facilitator. I'm deeply, with all the humbleness and with gratitude, thankful to my board, thankful to a great team that surrounds me and all of us at Escorts. We have a very, very open culture. We believe in quick decision making. We believe in transparency. And therefore, on the slide, as you can see, faces of the union leaders, to workers, to young graduates, to our leadership team and our board, our people in the shop floor, all what we are doing is because of their complete participation and complete oneness of the Escorts that we are today and the Escorts of what will always remain. I also want to thank our dealers, our suppliers, and our partners. We just don't want our channel partners to be partners of the business of the today, but as I mentioned on the FY25 visioning board, we will continue to ensure that we invite them in having them to participate for the future that we all can collectively make, from innovation on the way of we do the way we do business and how we can continuously improve and create a culture in Escorts where we create an aspect where it is important to continuously challenge ourselves each day, each week, each month to improve on how we can improve our company in all aspects. I will always remain indebted to our board of directors who are present here today for their great advice. In the last 18 months during the COVID, while we are statutory bound to meet in our board meetings and on our various other meetings that we do, but I do want to thank them, my board, for making time even beyond that and for the guidances and for many, many meetings that we had, which has resulted us and got us to where we are today. So thank you to all of you, to our directors here. I deeply value your participation and your guidance to me and to the entire team at Escorts. As I end the speech, we have made a short video of the COVID safety measures that the company took, which I have talked about, but we would like to give you a visual representation of the new way of living, because pandemic has become an aspect that has changed the way the world operates. So we want to ensure that we prepare grounds of policies and processes which will not get us by surprise. So safety, as I mentioned in the beginning of my speech, is an important aspect. So therefore, through the video that we will showcase to you, we'll give you a glimpse of a new norm and the new safety measures the company has taken and will continue to keep it alive. So with that, thank you for hearing my main speech. And before I go to the next leg of the agenda for today's meeting, please have a look at the video. Thank you.